for all of you for tuning in. Get your Bibles real quick or get your eyes on the scripture. Pull it up on your phone, whatever you need to do. Look at Acts chapter 3, verses 1 through 9. And we're going to read kind of fast. You're familiar with the text, so I don't have to spend a whole lot of time here. Now, Peter and John went up together into the temple at the hour of prayer, being the ninth hour. And a certain man lame from his mother's womb was carried, whom they laid daily at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask alms of them that enter into the temple. Who seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, asked an alms. Peter fastened his eyes upon him with John, and he said, look on us. Verse number 5 says, he gave heed unto them, expecting to receive something of them. Then Peter said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, give I thee. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And he took him by the right hand and lifted him up. Watch this. And immediately his feet and ankle bone received strength. But I want you to focus on verses 8 and verses 9. Verse 8 and verse number 9. Verse 8 said, and he leaping up stood and walked and entered with them into the temple, walking and leaping and praising God. And verse number 9 says, and all the people saw him walking and praising God. And all the people, verse number 9, saw him walking and praising God. If I would use for a subject tonight, it would be, that's a story behind my praise. Did you hear me? There's a story behind my praise. Now, you may not have time for me to tell you, but all you need to know is there's a story behind this praise. So many times, people see you. They see you praising God. They see you being excited and radical for God. They see you sweating and giving it all you got. And they say, don't take all that. I wouldn't do all that. You ain't got to do all that. But that may work for you. But I need you to know that when you see me praising God and giving God the glory and exalting his name, that is a story behind this praise. You just see me where I am today. But you need me to walk you back down memory lane. How God brought me and how God taught me and how God kept me and how God sustained me and how God made sure that I had everything I need, hallelujah, to be where I am today. So all you need to know is there's a story, woo, glory to God, behind this praise. Look at this. Point number one, I was just telling you, it's hard for many people to understand your praise, being that they're not aware of the magnitude of your story. See, most people don't understand your shout. Most people don't understand your hallelujah. Most people don't understand your thank you, Jesus, because they don't know the magnitude of your story. They didn't see you when you was crying. They didn't see you when you was going through. They didn't see you when your daddy walked off and left you. They didn't see you, glory to God, when loved one turned their back on you. They didn't see you struggling. They didn't see you being raised in the project. Y'all ain't talking to me now. They didn't see you, glory to God, having to get assistance with food stamps and government cheese. Oh, glory to God. But God, that's a story behind this praise. Glory to God. Most of us have never, ever told our whole testimony. You didn't hear me? I said most of us have not ever told our whole testimony. We tell the part that people can handle and still believe that we're saved. Still believe we've been called to preach. still believe we've been called to be apostles and evangelists and prophets and teachers and pastors. We tell the part people can handle in church and won't think we some kind of phony or some kind of fake. Paul would often speak of some of the places that God delivered him from. Paul said things like this: I used to persecute the people of God. I tried to kill the church. I tried to destroy everyone that was coming in the name of God. But that same man, Paul, wrote over 2/3 of the New Testament. That same man, Paul, became the greatest apostle in history, because there's a story, woo, God, behind this praise. There's a story behind this hallelujah. There's a story behind my thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Not only have God delivered us from some things before we were saved, but even since we've been saved. Oh, I can't get no help now. I can't get no real folks now. You can talk about, look where he bought me from. But even since I've been saved, oh God, God has brought me through some serious situations. God has brought me, oh God, on the verge, glory to God, of losing my marriage, of losing my ministry. I won't talk now. Losing everything pertaining to me. But God, I say, God, sustain it. God revived it. God restored it. Y'all won't talk now. And God saved it, kept it from falling. Hallelujah. And I tell you, that's why you see me sweat and giving God all I got and giving God all I have, because there's a story behind this praise. Paul, even after he got saved, Paul said, let me tell you something. Let me give you my testimony. He said, I was beaten of the Jews 5 times, receiving 40 stripes, say one. He said, thrice I was beaten with rods. Once I was stoned. Thrice I suffered shipwreck. A night and a day I have been in the deep. He said, in journey often. Glory to God. He said, in pearls of waters. In pearls of robbers. In pearls by my own countrymen, the people that's supposed to be for me, the people who supposed to be my supporters, the people that's supposed to be my co-laborers in the gospel. Oh, I know what he's talking about. The ones you think that are with you, they end up being your greatest enemy. Oh, God, the Bible said it was the one that came into the house of God and took, we went into house of God together and ate bread together. It was that one that rose their heel up against me. I'm telling you, the people closest to you sometimes become your greatest enemy, but that's a story. Woo-wee. Behind my praise, Paul said, in weariness and painfulness, in watching often, in hunger, in thirst, in cold and nakedness. Besides all that, he said, I had the care of the church on me daily. Y'all won't talk to me now, but God. I almost gave up, but God. I almost threw in the towel. That's what Paul's saying. But God, I almost, my God, whoo, lost my mind. But God. So that's why when you see me praising God, don't look at me strange. Just know that there's a story behind this praise. Woo! So I believe if Paul was here today, he'll say, if you see me praising God, don't mind me. Well, the best thing you can do is join me. Because if you only knew all God brought me through and all God brought me from, you'll understand my praise. You'll understand why I go and give God all I got. You'll understand why I give him and I praise him with my whole being, because there's a story behind this praise. Hey, when I was growing up, the old saints used to sing a song. Some of y'all might remember this if you grew up Pentecostal. But we would sing a song and say, you don't know like I know what he done for me. And then the saints would get real good and sassy. They'll say, you can't tell it like I can. What he done for me. So I'm trying to tell you, you really don't know my whole story. You really don't know all God did for me. Oh God, you've been privy to some things, but you ain't been privy to everything. So all you need to know is there's a story behind my praise. Now, every thank you, Jesus, every hallelujah, every Lord, I bless you. There's a story behind it. Woo! Hallelujah. Point number two. When God reveals himself to you in incredible ways, then you owe God an incredible praise. You didn't hear what I said, did you? I said when God reveals himself to you in incredible ways, then you owe God an incredible praise. I can't get no help now. I said, when God reveal himself to you like he have in the past, like he have in the pandemic, like he have down through the years, when God reveals himself to you in incredible ways, then you owe God an incredible praise. Somebody say, I owe God. Somebody say, I owe God an incredible praise. An incredible God deserves an incredible praise. He's been incredible. He's been wonderful. He's been outstanding. He's been excellent. He's been magnificent. Y'all won't talk to me now. Isaiah said, Isaiah called him wonderful. Counselor. Then he said, the mighty God. The everlasting Father. Then he stopped and said, the Prince of Peace. Oh my God. That's who he is. And so you need to understand, he's incredible. So when God show up in your life and show out in your life, he deserves an incredible praise. This reminds me of David. The Ark of the Covenant had been missing. It was in somebody else's house. And bless God, one day, David was able to recover the Ark of the Covenant. And when David recovered the Ark of the Covenant, I wish I had Bible readers, David started dancing on his way back home before he got to church and before he got back to the city. See, when you start thinking on the goodness of Jesus and all he's done for you, baby, your soul will cry out in the middle of the street, in the middle of Walmart, in the middle of Longhorn Steakhouse. Y'all won't talk now. Woo! I said, you'll cry out. Sometimes you have to contain yourself. Because when you just start thinking of how incredible God has been, an incredible praise will well up on the inside. And you can't help yourself. Before you know it, your hands will go up. Your feet will start moving. Your mouth will join in. And before you know it, you'll say, hallelujah, glory to God. Woo! So David recovered the Ark of the Covenant and started dancing in the street. And bless God, David was so blessed and so overwhelmed about how God had intervened. The Bible said David danced out of his clothes. Now, I'm not encouraging you, unless you're at home by yourself, to dance out of your clothes. But I am telling you that your dance ought to cause other people to stop and notice your praise. I said, y'all missed that. I said, your praise ought to be so radical for God that it ought to cause other people to stand and give attention to your praise. And David's wife, looked out the window and said, what's wrong with David? He's supposed to be a king. He's supposed to be dignified. He's supposed to be sophisticated. He's supposed to be politically correct. Glory to God. He's supposed to make sure that he's orderly. But David said, baby, you just don't know what this means to me. God has been incredible in my life. And people stop you from praising God. You know what he did. You know where he brought you from. He raised me up off a sick bed. No, I take that back. Off a death bed. Give him 40% chance to live. Woo! By the doctor. And the doctor said, call the family in. Glory to God, because I don't think he'll live through the night. And I had sepsis. I had both lungs filled with pneumonia. Oh, God. And the second day on the ventilator, my kidneys shut down. Had to go on dialysis. I'm talking about an incredible God. When he reveals himself to you in an incredible way, then you owe God an incredible praise. And I promise God, I thought I had been praising him, but laying down on the hospital bed, I promise God, if you raise me up, if you give me deliverance, if you bring me out of this hospital, I praise you of the rest of my life. I praise you like I'm losing my mind. I praise you with everything I got in me. I promise God, if you take me off dialysis, I was on dialysis for 7 weeks. And after 7 weeks, God took me off and delivered me from going to dialysis. Oh, God, that was incredible. I said that was incredible in my life. So I know I owe God an incredible praise. Y'all won't talk to me. Excuse me. Y'all excuse me. I said, I owe God. Maybe he did anything for you. I can't speak for you. But every time I turn around, God's making a way. Even in a pandemic, God's been making a way. He's been making sure every bill get paid. And then having some money left over to even put in savings. Y'all won't talk to me now. I said, God, in a bad time, in a famine, in a hard time, in a hard place, he showed himself strong on the behalf of his people. So God is incredible. So we owe God an incredible praise. Oh, God. Oh, Jesus. I bless him at all times. And his praise shall continually be in my mouth. I try to encourage other people to praise God and to testify and to give God glory, to live a life that's pleasing to God. But I can't do it for them. I can't worry about them. I got to make sure that I open this mouth and I give God the glory and I give God the praise. And not just a praise, but an incredible praise. A praise that takes all I got. A praise that comes from my belly. A praise that comes out of my spirit. Not just going through the motions, but my whole being. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Last point. Don't ever let anyone talk you down as it relates to praising God, because praise is comely to the upright. Y'all didn't hear that, did you? Ooh, I gotta say that again. Don't let anyone, I don't care where they come from, how many degrees they got, how sophisticated they are, and how proper they're trying to be. I said, don't let no one talk you down from praising God, because praise is comely to the upright. Psalm 33:1 says, rejoice in the Lord, O ye righteous, for praise is comely to the upright. Y'all ain't saying it to me. The Amplified Bible said this, rejoice in the Lord, O ye uncompromising righteous. You're upright, you upright in right standing with God. For praise is becoming and appropriate for those who are upright in heart. Did y'all hear that? Praise is comely and appropriate. I said praise is becoming and appropriate. Somebody said praise is becoming and appropriate for me. Now, I feel right at home when I give God praise. I feel right comfortable when I give God praise. I feel like I'm living up to my purpose in the earth. My purpose in the earth is to be a praise in everything I do, in how I live, not just in the church, not just running around the building, but my praise is how I live, how I carry myself. Being the light of the world, being the salt of the earth, that's my praise to God. And I wouldn't let nobody stop me from being a praise in the earth, because praise is becoming an appropriate for me. Woo-wee. As a matter of fact, I was created to praise God. I wish I had Bible readers. I said I was created. You need some scripture? I got one. Psalm 139 and 14 said, I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knows right well. That's why I praise thee, because I was fearfully and wonderfully made, and I was made to praise God. I'm telling you, it does something for the believer when the believer releases a praise. Y'all won't talk now. You can't stay sick. You can't stay depressed. You can't stay disgusted. You can't stay in fear. You can't stay in doubt. You can't stay in unbelief. I'm telling you, when you give God praise, change the thought of you. As Paul and Silas, they was in jail. They was locked up. Glory to God. And looked like they wasn't getting out no time soon. But the Bible said around about midnight, they began to sing and they began to pray. I dare you to praise God. God will bring you out of whatever you in. I said God will loose you from whatever holding you. I said God will free you from whatever have you bound. Because there's a story behind your praise. And when you praise God, you're saying to the enemy, enemy, you can't stop me. I owe God this praise. And I won't let nothing separate me from my praise. Oh, God. That's why we should often reflect on the things God has done for us. Because when you start saying, I remember when, a praise arise up in you. When you start reminiscing, y'all won't talk to me, of all the things God has done, you don't need no praise team. You don't need no worship leader. You don't need no musician. Baby, when you start thinking on the goodness of Jesus and all he's done for you, your soul will cry out, hallelujah. And you'll begin to praise God for saving you. Maybe you ain't glad you saved. Maybe you ain't glad you baptized in the Spirit. But I'm tonight, I praise God for saving me. I praise God for keeping me. I praise God for delivering me. I praise God for healing me. And most of all, I praise God for keeping me alive. Woo! It should be easy to praise God when you get in the presence of other people. Somebody said, why you say that? Because you're supposed to be praising God at home. But we praising God all day. The songwriter said, this is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. So when I get with the saints and the other believers, it's not hard for me to get into praise, because I live in a praise. I wake up in a praise. I go to Walmart in a praise. I drive down the street in a praise. I go to the restaurant in a praise. And if you mess with me in one of them places, a praise will come out. Because praise is in me. Praise is comely. Praise is appropriate. Praise is becoming. It's just who I am and what I do. Woo! So y'all are valued. things you should have. You should have a word life. You should have a prayer life. And you should have a praise life. I'll say it again, because you probably missed it. You should have a word life. You should have a prayer life. And you should have a praise life. Y'all ain't talking to me now. I declare to you, if you have a word life and a prayer life and a praise life, no good thing will he withhold from you, and everything the devil try to throw at you, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord shall deliver them out of them all. And if your praise got you in it, your praise will get you out of it. Don't stop praising God because you fell into a temptation or affliction or a situation. Don't stop praising God. That's the time to take your praise to even a greater level, because I'm telling you, a praise will get you in it, but a praise will get you out. Ooh. So many people don't have a praise life, and they come to church, want to piggyback off your praise life. They want you to create the atmosphere. They want you to raise a praise. They want you to enter into the gates with thanksgiving and into his court with praise. They want you, glory to God, to hand walk and spoon feed them into the presence of God. But I encourage you, don't, after this season that we've been quarantined and in a pandemic, when we do come back together, whatever that shall be, we should have no problem giving God a praise, because our praise should have been tested during this time to see if it was authentic. Ooh. And if you couldn't praise God outside the church, you need to sit down when you get inside. Y'all quiet now. Y'all quiet now. Because it could just be body exercise, and it could just be going through the motion. Because a building being closed should not have affected your praise. Woo! Y'all mad at me, but that's okay. I'm going to tell you the truth, and I'm finna get ready to go off. I said, but a building being closed should not have affected your praise. My praise is not dependent on a building. My praise is not dependent on a praise team. My praise is not dependent on being, glory to God, hallelujah, with musicians playing. I'm telling you, up above my head, I can hear music. I'm a musician, and I can go play myself, but I hear music. I hear music in the air. When I start thinking about Jesus, I don't need no keyboard. Woo! I can praise God all by myself, without anyone, because I know what he did for me. That's a story. That's a story. Somebody say it with me. That's a story. Comment that. Tweet that. Put it on your Facebook. That's a story behind my praise. And my hands, I continue to raise. The devil can't stop me. He should have killed me when he had the chance. He should have killed me when I was in St. Francis Hospital in the ICU on the breathing machine for 5 whole days. He should have killed me, but God didn't let it be so. And since God let me live, I'm going to praise him with everything I got. I'm going to praise him if I do it by myself. I'm going to praise him if won't nobody help me, nowhere, no time. I promise God, I'll praise him the rest of my days. There's a story behind my praise. Make the devil mad. Put it in the atmosphere. So there's a story behind my praise. There's a story behind my hallelujah. So when you see me shouting, when you see me living for Jesus, when you see me on the blessed side of God, know that there's a story behind my praise. And I tell you, do it, and do it with all you got. Give God your best praise. Even now, throw your hands up. I said, throw your hands up and begin to praise him now. Father, we bless you. Father, Father, we give you glory. We give you honor. We give you praise. We magnify your name. We exalt you. We extol you. Oh, God, we bless you. Oh, God, we glorify you. We lift you up. Nobody greater than you. Nobody like unto you. Nobody compares to you. You're in a class all by yourself. So we praise you tonight. I bless your name. I love you, God. I worship you. I adore you, God. Woo! Hallelujah. I dare you to praise him now. I dare you to praise him now. I dare you to praise him now. Praise the Lord. All you people, let everything that have breath praise ye the Lord. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him according to his excellent greatness. Praise him. Woo, God, for his wondrous act to the children of men. Praise God for what he already done. Praise him for what he's doing right now. And if you really want to make the devil real mad, praise him for what he's going to do or allow you to do in the future. There's a story. There's a story behind my praise. When the man that had been at the gate, when he was healed, didn't have to beg no more. Didn't have to have out his little cup trying to get some money. But God healed him. He went in the temple, start leaping, start walking, and start praising God. And the Bible said the people said, is this the same man that was sitting outside at the gate? I believe if the man was here tonight, he would say, you just don't know. There's a story behind my praise. You don't know how many days I was discouraged, sitting at the gate. Sometimes people would help me, and sometimes they wouldn't. I had to suffer. I had to go through. But God sent Peter and God sent John to deliver me by the power of God. And there's a story behind my praise. God bless you tonight. God keep you is my prayer. I pray you were blessed by the word. Was anybody blessed by the word of God? There's a story behind my praise. Hallelujah. Glory to the Lamb of God. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, bless your name. Hallelujah. That's a story. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, I bless you. I bless you all day. I bless you. I bless you from the rise of the sun to the going down of the same. I bless you, oh God. Hallelujah. My soul delight in you. My soul doth magnify you. And my spirit doth rejoice in the God of my salvation. Hallelujah. 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 Bless your name. Bless you. Yeko masata. Hande de bo shikata. Yele bo sita masheke. Yeke de bo siya namaha. Oh, I bless you now. Yeko satamaya. Oh, basakada mashia. Ha, yeko shata. Hande de bo sa. God bless you. I bless you right now. There's a story behind this praise. Was anybody blessed by the word? God bless you. I pray you were blessed by the word of God. Make sure you decree and declare. That's a story behind my praise. Whatever you do, give God the praise. Give God the glory. Walk through your house. Throw your hands up. Open your mouth. And give God the praise. Because truly, he's worthy of all our praise. God bless you. Pray you were blessed tonight. Pray for me. I'll pray for you, Father. Thank you for your word. Thank you for your anointing. Thank you for your power. Hallelujah. Thank you for your spirit. Thank you. Thank you that somebody heard your word tonight. As somebody will decree and declare that there's a story behind my praise. And they'll praise you when they begin to think of how good you've been, how much you've done for them. Oh, God, they can't even tell it all. They can't even remember something they've probably even forgotten all about. But I thank you that we'll praise you from the rise of the sun to the going down the same. We'll give you praise. We'll give you glory. Bless God. Hallelujah. We'll give you glory. We'll give you all the honor. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. Thank you for tuning in tonight. Thank all of you. I appreciate you so much. Pray for me. I'll pray for you. Do me one favor. Share the video with somebody. Share it with them if you don't mind. Tell them as a story behind your praise. God bless you. Have a great evening.